IVM.
All right, simplified is where they take stories that you can't understand and make it even more difficult to understand. If you need that in your life, it's called marriage. Simplified, three young men with a mission. Their names, Chuck, Naren and Sriket. That's right, simplify their names first. Simplify. New episodes out on the IVM podcast website, app or wherever you get your podcast from. All right, please note that the language and ideas presented on the show might not be suitable for everyone. If you're under 18, make sure your mom isn't around. If you're over 80, why is your mom around?
You're listening to Cyrus Says.
Here on Cyrus Says, people complain we have no music in our souls. So today we have Akriti Kakkar and DAWgeek in concert. Unison, harmony. Actually, they never met, but it's Cyrus Says.
Why follow your auntie's advice when you can follow Cyrus Says on Facebook and Twitter to stay updated about the latest shows?
Here on Cyrus Says, let's talk about unconscious moments. Unconscious moments happen to all of us. It's when you don't know in society what you're doing, but other people are observing you. For example, I see a lot of people with pens in their hands, very often in a conversation or when they're alone, sort of go into the digging of the ear, digging of the nose. Yes, I did put it up my nostril and the other one as well. And in the mouth, after the nostril. So I want you to understand your unconscious movements are being observed. So please remember, unconscious movements can destroy your credibility socially. So be very careful what you do and do not put it anywhere else. This is bad enough. Cyrus Says.
And that's what Cyrus says.
That's right, boys. Here are Cyruses.
Yeah,
we've got some. We've got our own guitarist. Let me introduce him. His name is DAWgeek.
Yes, my name is DAWgeek. That's his stage name. That's my stage name.
He doesn't want to be named by anything else.
No, my dad calls me DAWgeek now.
Everybody calls him DAWgeek now. People in the passport obviously DAWgeek aa gaya.
DAWgeek aa gaya.
Bajao. He starts playing the beautiful guitar. All right, let me just set this up here. On Cyrus Says, we're waiting for Akriti Kakkar, who unfortunately is stuck in traffic. She got into a fight with a policeman. Things are not looking good, but she will be here soon. In the meantime, we have DAWgeek, and we're all going to talk about is Swag Wali Bride, which is a
Swag Wali Bride
or yes. Swag. In the north we say one thing, the south is something else. So why don't you set that up for us? So it's a whole series, is it?
So it's a whole series that we are trying to make. It's about these old wedding songs, those folk melodies, those Punjabi melodies are really emotional.
Yeah. So give us a taste of one of the melodies so people know what you're talking about.
So the melody that we've used for Swag Wali Bride is Chediya Da Chamba.
Play, na?
Okay, I'll just play it. I'm a bad singer.
People, no, but people recall
yeah,
the tune.
They'll remember the melody. Yeah, yeah. So it's like...
Or they remember their wedding and say, why? Q! Huh. That's Punjabi, yeah?
Yeah, that's Punjabi. So these are these melodies that these aunties, they sing during a wedding with those dholes and those chamchas and all. And it's those songs when a bride is being... Like, a girl is getting married and she's going out of the house to the in-laws. And it's like a... Bye-bye song.
The farewell song.
Yeah, so
all the happy farewell song also sometimes. Thank God, finally.
Yeah, so all these melodies, these are really emotional. They have a value to it. Mm-hmm. What we are trying to do is we are grabbing these melodies and we are converting into songs that people can enjoy and dance upon and happily get married using these songs. Mm-hmm. It can be used for bridal entries. And we are changing the meaning. We are having some additional compositions to it, new lyrics that converse the whole emotional and like really nostalgic songs
so
into.
So, question to ask you here quickly, DAWgeek, is you've been married?
No, I'm not. I'm just a kid.
He's just a kid. All right, fair enough. But it's important to know if you're married. Do you understand
I'm not.
The whole concept of marriage from the inside. So, let me figure this out firstly. So, this is a whole, almost like a tribute to weddings.
I think it's a new way of brides to take an avatar of not being that emotional during their weddings and just to be fun loving and enjoying the whole process of being married and being a independent and a bride that's happy about getting married and going somewhere else rather than just being that emotional sort of a bride who is just crying and being conscious during the weddings because of the society or whatever. So the thing that we are doing here is to give them a new perspective.
But whose idea was this?
This was Akriti's idea.
Akriti's been married how many times?
Once.
What is my guy? I don't understand. If there's no experience, how do you explain all this? Huh?
So Akriti got married last year.
Right.
And
did you
I
pay the music for her?
No. Not back then.
Did you pay Swag Wali Brides?
So Swag Wali Bride is her term that was tossed by her best friend during her wedding.
Okay.
So she was posting her cool pictures of her wearing those sunglasses during the wedding,
right,
just
right.
having fun. So, you know, you post pictures on Instagram and she used the hashtag Swag Wali Bride. Mm. And that's how it came into existence. Mm. So I think after a year, Akriti, I'm sure she must be having this in her mind since a long time.
We'll talk to her, we'll understand from her perspective. But let's talk about DAWgeek for a minute. I'm most fascinated.
Okay.
Where did the name come from?
So, I became an artist and I needed a stage name for myself. Mm-hmm. My real name is Devansh Bhatia. Mm-hmm. And I thought that's not something that goes with what I want to do as an artist. Mm-hmm. So, I was sitting in my room and I was looking myself in the mirror and I was thinking of names. Kya karu? Mm-hmm. And I see a geek, like that's what I am. I'm mm-hmm. like a studious boy since mm-hmm. like when I was in school. So I have this mirror and I look at the person, like that's me, and I'm wearing these specs. I'm geeky about things. Mm-hmm. And so that was a term that I registered. Like, theek hai, geek to mil gaya. Abhi kya karu? Now my name is Devansh. Mm-hmm. I wanted something from D.
Right.
So I was working upon these softwares, like the software that we make music on.
Right.
They are called the DAWs, DAW.
Oh, that's what it is.
Yeah. So it's digital audio workstations.
I just could spell DAWs.
Yeah. Yeah. So we call them DAWs.
Correct.
And since I work on all the DAWs that are available, mm-hmm. I just combine DAW and geek. And it became DAWgeek.
And let's hear music celebration with a new name.
Yeah.
DAWgeek. Wow, not bad. One, and the simple message here, which is two words, you can do a good song. I really enjoyed
that. This was impromptu. Yeah.
No, it's fine. It's fantastic. Okay, DAWgeek, 2012, I was at Wilson College, you reminded
me. Yeah,
and
yeah.
You were already a composer.
I think that was a teenager. Yeah, that was my first few years of making music, and I think that was the first song that you promoted for us back then. It was called PK Machala. It was an anti-drunken driving campaign.
A big campaign for anti-drunken driving,
right,
which you get to see from Wilson College because Marine Drive is filled with it.
Right. So Thompson and these kids from Wilson College had started this whole thing.
Where did they find you?
So Thompson and I, we go back to our designing days. I wanted to become an automobile designer and he was studying for his...
You're a car geek actually, not a guitar
geek. Yeah, I'm passionate about cars.
Okay, so after the show, can you just take a look at my Honda?
Oh, I will.
Spend some time under the old lady, please.
Yeah. So we met back at our design school and that's where he found me. And Thompson was the guy who introduced me to music. Mm-hmm. After a year, he was doing this campaign and I learned a few things about making music.
So you didn't play guitar all till then?
I did play the guitar, but producing music is a different game.
Right.
So he invited me upon the show for his music, for the track PK Machala. Mm-hmm. And we had produced a song he had composed and that's how he came up with it. And thankfully you had supported... Yeah. For that whole campaign.
Considering I had drunk and driven all my life up till that point, then I stopped immediately. It was a terrible thing to do, ladies and gentlemen. If you want to drive, drive like Virat Kohli on the cricket field.
Don't
drive and drink. And if you do drink, I'm not against drinking, but now we don't need to drive anymore because you've got so many people out there.
Yes.
I won't mention the different options, but there's so many, including people who are just passing by.
Right.
So, but let's get back to you. You were a young kid. Mm-hmm. You composed, this was your first foray into producing. What exactly do you do when you say producing as against composing?
So being a musician is a thing. Now making music in an electronic domain is a different thing. Mm-hmm. I was really fascinated by electronic music back in 2012 when it started booming all over the world. So I learned these techniques to come up with different sounds and play around with beats and the whole process of using instruments that are not naturally available. It's like you can just pick up a guitar. Oh, no, this isn't...
And this is naturally available.
This is an acoustic instrument.
Could you use the back of the guitar?
Oh, maybe.
Yeah.
So like making beats like...
Okay, wait, let me set up. Ladies and gentlemen, he's going to actually produce original sound using only the wooden part of the guitar, right?
Okay.
All right.
This is just a...
show us.
I'll just show it to you.
Not bad. Now do it on my head.
On your head?
Come on.
How would it sound?
Not bad. The guy's got a lot of talent. This is what I call third world musical talent.
बहुत कुछ बड़ा है यार.
Instrument नहीं है, फिर भी कुछ कर सकता है. बजाओ something.
बहुत कुछ. Like your head was heavy.
Yeah,
what's happening?
It's like an old Perth wicket. It's got a bounce on my head.
Yeah, I like the sound of it.
Sorry, I interrupted you again. Please carry on.
Okay, so I was saying, the process of making electronic music, I learned these techniques all throughout 2013-14. I started doing covers and remixes on YouTube. And I think 2017 was the year I had a lot of collaborations. Shankarji invited me to work upon one of
Shankar,
his
Shankar, Esan, Loy, Shankar.
Yes. So there was
Why didn't Esan and Loy invite you? What's wrong with them?
No, this track was composed by Shankar.
Only Shankar. Don't answer my question. I'm just kidding.
Okay, so...
So you played along with him?
So I produced the track for him. He invited me to work upon this track called Tutari. It was for Ganpati.
And can you play a bit of that?
No.
Why?
See, performing electronic music, I need those DJs, all those things.
Yeah. But we have all the equipment here because I've got my own Shavan here who's a genius.
Oh, okay.
And every Ganpati felicitation or any bundle, you'll find him there performing.
Okay.
Yeah. And when I mean performing, I mean in many different ways.
So Shankarji invited me to work upon Tutari. So I gave it a very electronic soundscape and him with his desi roots and his melodies.
He's one of those all-type musicians.
Oh, man,
because from west to east, he's got everything.
He's got
on
everything.
His
and
so it'll be difficult to please such a guy because, you know, there's...
No, in fact, he made it so easy for me to just explore and experiment with his composition.
Is his son on the track as well?
Yeah, he sung on the track. And it sounds so different. It's got electronic instruments. It got those desi tashas and dholes, those Maharashtrian tutari. It's called tutari. It's got this tutari. And I made a sound, which is electronic, but it's based upon the sound of tutari.
So from traditional, took it straight to electronics.
Yeah, straight to electronics. So that was something cool that we had come up with. And Akriti then approached me for this song. And that's how we started making the song, and it
came. So tell us a little bit about Swag Wali Bride now from your perspective as a producer.
Okay, so now this melody is really emotional.
Can you play a little bit for us?
Okay.
I was told I don't want to talk. They'll just keep playing, and we can relax for the whole episode.
I think she's just so.
You sound like Akriti.
No,
it was exactly like Akriti. It was fantastic.
So it was this melody. Na 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 na. So it's like really emotional when you listen to it.
But let's understand again how it's made. So the composition edition is done by Akriti, lyrics by Manoj Jadhav.
Yes.
Music produced by DAWgeek, that's you, and video directed and conceptualized by Chirag Arora. Mm-hmm. So how does it work?
So Akriti comes home, she sings a track, we compose the parts that are not, like the additional composition, we do it, and then Manoj pens down the lyrics. So we have a new song with fused to a folk melody, and we combine them, we make a structure. Now it's given to me, I produce the whole soundscape. Like, I add beats to it, I make build-ups, and we had to come up with a drop which is, like, really fun. So it's like a flip side. The song starts, like, really slow and mellow, and it's emotional, and then it takes a turn, it gets a build-up, and it's suddenly a dance track.
Wow.
So that's how the approach was, and my approach is really electronic. I don't listen to desi stuff much.
What the hell, yaar?
I don't. And that's a beauty about it. When Akriti is there in the studio with all her desi influences, and I come from a different world of music.
So electronic meets desi, and you'll come together in almost like a marriage which you're talking about here, and you have a Swag Wali composition.
Yes, it's a Swag Wali composition, and it sounds really cool, and it's a whole flip side of what you've been listening to.
Right.
And
I'll tell you what we'll do. Let's take a quick break here, and when we come back, we'll magically produce Akriti, and then we'll understand what you're talking about.
Okay.
We'll get her to sing this magical composition live for us.
Hey friend, so if you're listening to a podcast right now, you're probably some kind of a nerd. A nerd at heart, at least. So maybe, just maybe, you might like another podcast. about nerds, by nerds, and for nerds.
It's called Geek Fruit, a community to unite estranged geeks from across India and later on the world. We talk about television, movies, science fiction, adventure, fantasy, etc. Anything nerdy, it's all here on Geek Fruit. You can catch a fresh episode every Monday, and you can check us out on any of your favorite podcast apps, like my favorite podcast app, the IVM podcast app. Give me my money, IVM. Good plug.
Happy listening, you nerds.
All right, back here on Cyrus Says. Finally, we've got Akriti stuck in traffic. No worries. Police can be brutal, but you made it. And lots to discuss because Swag Wali Bride, as I've been corrected 10 times.
Yes.
By this young man who won't tell us his real name, but we got it out of him finally.
You did?
What's his real name?
Devansh Bhatia.
Wow.
But I promise you, if you call out, you know, in a busy marketplace, you call out to him saying, Devansh, he will not even look back. Huh? I don't think he registers that name.
But if you shout Swag Wali Bride, he turns immediately.
Yeah. He's a Swag Wali Bride. Parati, like I say,
looks
all
like
time.
It, yeah. looks like a hip butt, no? The hip hop version of the same
new
thing.
Beanie that I
wearing a beanie,
today.
Yeah. Akriti Kakkar has just joined us, singer musician. She needs no introduction. She's all over the place and right at the top of her game. But let's talk about the album more. Is it an album? What is
it's
it?
It's a single.
It's a single
for now.
But it's a single where you will do more, right?
From what yes, there are two more in this particular series where the first one essentially talks about how a bride is not supposed to be all shy.
But you've only been married once, Akriti. Aapko kya pata hai? You should have at least 5 marriages. Yeah. Talk,
no? No, on the only one that I've had, I was pretty badass for a typical Punjabi
shadi. That's not what I heard.
Really?
He told us about the shadi and some friend and all the masti and color around it.
So what did you tell him?
You'll have to hear the episode, or episode, whatever it's called. Right, so is this based on a personal experience?
Yes, it is. A lot of people, you know, my own friend started to, my best friend, in fact, her name is Ankita Chavla, and she coined this hashtag, Swag Wali Bride, and she started tagging all my pictures. Because I was probably very atypical as a bride.
No, I think you had the conservative outfit on, but you had sunglasses.
Sunglasses on, yeah.
Yeah, sunglasses was just like for a couple
of
pictures.
This is India.
Yeah, I mean, whatever it was, everybody expected me to be very well behaved and very, like, you know, shy and like coy and very, matlab, dheere dheere chalo.
I thought parents were thinking, toh bach gaya, paisa bach gaya, we have a singer already. You don't call Dalal Mehndi for this function.
But he was actually there.
What are you saying? You're kidding me.
Yeah,
you're joking,
really,
right?
No, he was
tunak to me, I say.
So we actually finished the fairas fatafat se, and we ran into this hangar where there was a stage, and I went onto the stage and I said that I've been singing all my life on other people's weddings, and this is a major part of my profession. How can I not sing on my own wedding? So I made my husband sing. I made everybody who I saw there sing.
It's a Punjabi wedding. Everybody sings anyway.
Yeah, but like, you know, we had so many singer friends and musician friends.
I can imagine.
Shankarji was there. He ended up
This is great, yaar. If you're an actual musician and you're top of your line, all the big ones are known to you and all that, you have a wedding there.
It's not called top of the line. It's called being loved.
Yeah, being loved. And then they all just... I can imagine. If Shankar Sash, then Shan will say, I have to sing. And then before you know it, you have a full concert, probably the best of the year.
It was
it
was really, really beautiful.
Where was your wedding?
It was in Delhi.
Okay. It has to be in Delhi because you can't fit all these musicians in Bombay.
Yeah, and like 1,000 people, which was much against my wishes. Yeah,
Naveen. I didn't get the cut. I didn't make the list yet. Not even valet parking. Not even catering. Not even outside security. Kuch nahi.
Not loved, no, that's fine.
No singing talent. But, I'm not loved. True. Okay, Akriti, we are again interrupting you. The whole point was that because of your own experience and what Ankita, your friend, said,
yes,
this idea came on you to sort of take the old folksy Punjabi.
Because I think it's going all extinct, you know. Anybody who gets married, any friends of mine, every...
Yo-Yo Honey Singh has singularly destroyed it on his own. Yeah.
I don't know about that, but I feel that, you know, everybody wants to play these folk songs because they have that whole emotional relevance.
But they feel it's uncool now.
Yeah, because of the sound. You know, nobody wants to hear a dholak and dholak yuppa chammach wala sound nowadays. Nobody understands that.
Mummy, aapke wedding nahi hai, meri wedding hai.
Exactly what
something
people
like that,
say.
Yeah.
So I felt that, you know, the power of folk music needs to be brought back, and if it has to be brought back, it has to be old wine in a new bottle, and the meaning of those songs has to change. So specifically with Chidiyan Da Chamba, this particular song that we've brought back in Swag Wali Bride, usme the lyrics said, we are a flock of birds and you're going to marry us off and we're going to go away and we're never coming back.
The literal translation is always fun.
But that's what it literally means.
We are a flock of birds and we're going to fly away and
never come back.
Never come back. It's something my wife every day. Then.
So we thought that aisa nahi hai. Look at me. I know of a lot of other people who meet.
Don't look at DAWgeek.
No, no, no.
He's not had a marriage. I've already checked with him. Do you have a girlfriend, DAWgeek?
No.
तो क्या करते तुम?
I know already.
You बजाओ electronics.
I बजाओ.
Stop it. Calm down. In the world we live in, don't make any sexist comments. You'll both be in jail.
No, the guitar.
No, too late. Too late.
Edit ho jayega jaise bologe.
Or not. Or not. He'll find out. Sorry, Akriti. Go on.
So, I'm also losing thought.
So you want to preserve the culture. See, let's understand. I think it's a very innocent and nice thought. Because what happens is India is changing so fast. Mm. Everything's happening so quick. Punjabi weddings, which are always a mainstay of Indian culture, and you know, seen in our movies and everything else, also have changed over the years.
Yeah.
And as you said, are we losing the old?
I think we are. And I think the only way of bringing it back is to make it more understandable, relatable, and compatible to our generation.
So you change the lyrics.
We've created a whole new section. We've only taken the mukhra, which is the first few lines, the first verse from the folk. Mm-hmm. And we've created a whole new verse, which is a new composition and new lyrics, where I feel that I apply this to myself and to every other bride or girl who would be getting married at some point in time. She says that her upbringing is fabulous. She trusts her parents with whatever, you know, they've taught her until now and prepared her for the life henceforth. And Sasural bhejne wala, this whole rasam, why is it supposed to be all like aise rone dhone wala? You know, it can be.
But that's also part of it.
Of course, being emotional, I'm not saying don't be emotional. Be all super swag and keep dancing and all that. Being emotional is natural, but if you can do the same thing with a little smile, you know who you're getting your daughter married to, right?
Sometimes.
Most times.
Depends which part of the Punjab you're from.
So yeah, and I'm just trying to show the world a kind of different perspective towards weddings, where we see so many brides who are entering sometimes on a bike, they're getting their own barat. Why are brides supposed to be the victim on the shadi? Everybody else is having fun. Most of the brides are supposed to just stay like this.
Demure,
not move,
sad.
Niche dekho, dheere dheere chalo.
Yeah, your life is changing. Yeah.
Sab dekh rahe hain, sab log kya bolenge. Ye mere saath hua tha. A lot of my older aunts in the family had called my mom.
I cannot see you in a pallu, for sure.
I had a pallu, but like it was somewhere here. But whatever, I
lifted started out as a pallu, it ended up like that back thing that you have.
No, it was never. Like a ghungat anyway. Yeah. But my aunt had literally called my mother saying, "Bahut maza aaya shaadi pe, lekin bachche aajkal bahut peete hain na, humne dekha to." Mama ne kaha,
"Was it Punjabi wedding, Gujarati wedding? What's the problem?"
So, no, whatever it was, but usually the bride and groom are not supposed to drink. So I don't drink anyway. Hmm. They thought that I was having so much fun and I'd let loose.
I saw
to
you walk
extent.
In with a bottle. I don't know what you're talking about.
You're lying. Gladly, it's a radio sort of a bottle. Yeah. Nobody can see. But they all thought that I was so happy high that I was dancing because of that. But I was just genuinely happy that I was getting
married.
And
because you're from the industry, maybe they have their own prejudices and
maybe.
You know, colorful life and all that.
Maybe, but I think aaj ke time mein bhi bahut judge kiya jata hai un logo ko.
Stereotype is called.
Agar you know, if the bride is, you know, holding a glass of champagne, to uska matlab wo cultured hi nahi hai. Aur immediately next second agar uska yahan tak ghungat aa jayega aur koi pair chuhegi to bahut achhi hai wo. You know, it doesn't mean that is how you sort of categorize a good bride and a bad girl. You know, upbringing, suddenly you have decided.
Why can a good bride be a bad girl? That's what I would have liked.
But that
anyway,
is what
that's
you're
story.
I'm not saying bad girl, I'm saying that.
Different sides to.
You see, when you attend somebody else's wedding, if it's your best friend's wedding, don't you dance like a crazy person?
When I used to drink, yes. But I haven't drunk for 2 years.
Indian
men without drinking are terrible dancers. With drinking, it is as movement.
No, you need to meet my husband then.
The bhangra is different. I'm talking about come to a Bombay experience. See, Punjabi weddings are different because people basically know to dance to one style.
Yeah.
But when you come here and you go to one of these discos or college functions or something when you're younger,
you don't know
how to even move. No, they do some kind of, you know, it's rubbish. And the girl is like, oh God. Very bad.
Yeah,
okay, let's get back to Swag Wali Bride. Mm-hmm. So you're trying to preserve the culture here. Is this correct? In a
it
sense?
Is, yes. We're trying to bring back the folk music in a way that we all, you know, sort of connect to it more. And agar koi bhi lady sangeet jo pehle hua karta tha, now it's only become a sangeet. And what do we essentially dance to on a sangeet? It's only film songs.
Correct.
You know, so
sangeet now has a totally different meaning. You just get drunk completely and dance to film songs.
Yeah, like dance to
the
whatever.
The same ten songs.
Exactly. They're over still, and over again, over and over again.
Mehbooba is still number one. Laila O Laila is still being played. I don't know,
it's just being brought back again and again and again in new colors. So I feel that what if we try to bridge that gap and bring the whole folk color of music back again. And I'm not saying just Punjabi. You know, three as of now is what we're planning in this particular series. But if we see that it is being received with love, and we will probably pick up, you know, one Gujarati folk and bring it back and give it another new meaning.
Is it because of central government requirements? Why not an Oriya song, for example?
Why not? I don't know too many, so I know of a lot of Gujarati songs, so I'm saying that maybe. Okay, maybe Bengali as well.
Can we get a taste of the title track or the one track that we have?
Sure.
Then we'll come back and talk about the other two.
Yeah.
Now you'll get to hear it nicely.
So the lyrics of the new original composition are written by Manoj Yadav.
Yep.
And we've tried to create a new spin on the composition.
Produced by DAWgeek, let's not forget. Also, yes. Original lyrics by yourself. And video directed by
Original composition by me.
Original composition.
And original lyrics by Manoj Yadav.
And then video directed and conceptualized by Chirag Arora, who's your husband.
Yes.
There you go. Okay. Let's go.
Saadi lammi udaari ve asa mud nahi aana saada chidiyan da chamba ve babal asa ud jaana saadi lammi udaari ve saadi lammi udaari ve asa mud nahi aana we've also used real life swag wali brides ka video in this
matlab
we actually sourced footage from wedding photographers
and you literally look.
Yes, so you see girls from real weddings having fun on their own weddings as a part of this video. Hashtag Swag Wali Bride. जोड़ी रब ने बनाई वे चंदा की गवाही वे सो हमने ये खाई है हाँ जुग जुग संग जीना And now the new verse भेजना ससुराल स्माइलिंग चेहरों से तो हंस लो जरा तो नच लो जरा Oh, thank you, lakh lakh baar, maa papa dil se, jo pura kara, hai sapna mera. Ladki walo, tension na lo, dil da hai tyohar. Ek duniya banai hai, do duniya mila. ਸਾਡਾ ਚਿੜੀਆਂ ਦਾ ਚੰਬਾ ਵੇ ਬਾਬਲ ਅਸਾਂ ਉੱਡ ਜਾਣਾ ਹੈਸ਼ਟੈਗ ਸਵੈਗ ਵਾਲੀ ਬ੍ਰਾਈਡ ਸੋ ਹੇਅਰ ਇਜ਼ ਐਸੈਂਸ਼ਲੀ ਆਵਰ ਟੇਕ ਔਨ ਦ ਸੌਂਗ
ਵੂ ਗਿਵ ਇਟ ਅ ਕਲੈਪ And that's the modern way to go in music, I think, to mix and match so everybody comes to the party. It's a bit like what they do with Shakespeare or with the old poets in India and all that. You try and modernize it a little bit so that people come back and understand what they're missing. Which is
why. Because there are a lot of people who don't know about this stuff until now.
Because not everyone is getting married.
No, it's not.
Not everybody has a fat Punjabi wedding with 4,000 famous musicians. Some people are struggling. I've seen people in deep.
You don't attend other people's weddings.
I love Punjabi weddings. I'm actually very, you know, I like Punjabi culture a lot. I feel very comfortable there because they're all loud people. And everybody just speaks their mind, you know, so it's all out there. There's not too much holding back. But let's quickly talk about the other two because this allows you now, like you said, Gujarati, Oriya, whatever. There's no stop because our entire India is going in that direction almost. It's almost like a political movement you're starting. That we are forgetting the folk thing and you're not doing it in a rabid, angry way. You're saying, hey, come on, let's try and understand what this was
like. Yeah, like why can't
this
be
done? To your music and to your lyrics.
Right.
So you mix it up and, you know, whatever, hashtag and all these terms come in and all. So I think it's that allows you to do a lot. I mean, you can go across now.
We can. So the next song again is for now a Punjabi folk song, but we're trying to touch upon not just the bride having fun on her own wedding, but standing up for something right. And we've not really spoken about this in any interview as such right now, but what does a real swag wali bride do, and what is swag? Swag is a term that's being used in most songs right
now.
What
is swag?
Swag, I think for me, is just being who you are and being
West Indian man.
Huh?
That's swag, man.
No, yeah. I feel
so
that
being yourself, expressing
just
yourself.
Just being yourself,
yeah.
And you know, letting the world accept you the way you are.
And exactly what you said, that why should the woman look down and be demure and wear the gungat and the pallu and all?
Yeah,
all
I don't get it. Like, I really don't get it. My cousins have gotten married in that way, and I was holding her, and wo phoolon ki chadar ke niche wo chal ke aa rahi hai, and I'm like, dude, tu jaldi chal sakti ho. Wearing really comfortable shoes. She said, no, they're going to feel so bad. Pata nahi kya bolenge. And I looked at it, and I've seen not just one, but like so many weddings like that, where they're just expected to behave in a certain way. So why can't a woman just stand up and say, sorry, this is how I want to get married. This is what I want to do.
Swag Wali Bride has gone into Rahul Gandhi's woman empowerment movement. I'm warning you. How will you switch from left to right here? Or right to left? Huh?
You have a lot of massive political influence. In
my reference contexts are all wrong. But you know, I want to ask one last question. We have to wind up now. But what about elders? See, while you're trying to bring folk music back into the sort of mindset of the younger people,
right,
and saying let's keep our culture together in,
right,
and change, adapt. What about the elders who say, "Yaar, ye to poetra music hai," or whatever? You know, how do
you
how
know? We actually
react?
Did a rain check. We asked a lot of people of different ages to sort of hear the song and tell us what they feel. But on Facebook also, when I've posted this song, I have people tagging their mothers and saying, my mother's not, just writing their names and saying, my mother's not on Facebook, but let me tell you, she loves it. And she says that, ye bhi sunke main utni hi emotional ho rahi hu, jitna ye original vidai ka gana sunke hoti thi. So I feel that we're somewhere touching lives. Yeah.
Okay. All right. And the third concept, the third song that you've already got in
we'll
your mind?
We'll get there.
Okay, fair enough. But actually, I think this concept will last for long, and in your videos, you'll need some of those badly... let's face it, in any Punjabi wedding, is a badly behaved uncle. Let's call him Uncle Manish. I'll play Uncle Manish. I'll have the bottle in my hand.
We had a couple of them.
I've done weddings, Akriti, where I have to anchor, where by the second, and a good Punjabi wedding at Delhi farmhouse, after 2 hours, the uncles take over.
Yeah.
And this is a scene. A lot of uncles had gotten upset on our wedding. Were they requesting songs and screaming from down?
No, they were just coming on the stage and standing in a corner hoping for their turn to come.
Superb, superb. Yeah. You've got the highest paid singers in the world standing there. And Uncle Baljeet is saying, yaar, mera number kab aayega?
Nahin yaar, main ja raha hu yahan se, mere ko nahi gaane de rahe, koi baat hoti hai, ye ladke ladke aaj ke. Okay then.
Excellent. Alright, Akriti, sorry we have to end it here, but DAWgeek, thank you also for coming and speaking to us. We've learned so much about him. He's a mystery musician. But Akriti, of course, doing so well, new song, and a lot of potential to bring folk music or bring us closer to our roots in a sense without losing the modern way, which I
Absolutely.
Think is a more progressive way to do things in life. Excellent.
Thank you so much.
Is there any last song you want to sing for us?
Let's do a little bit of what we're coming up with next.
Superb.
The scale is fine for you.
No, very high.
They talk amongst themselves. Main to kya karte hain? I'm just an extra person.
Okay, just give me the scale. I'll catch a note.
You don't remember? You produced it.
What kind of producer do you don't remember?
What scale was it?
What about the scale of payment? Who gets what?
Nobody gets anything. Not even royalties nowadays.
The sad look in DAWgeek's eyes. I know who gets what.
सुई वे सुई टंगे पंगुड़े पैगर प्यार तेरे नाल गुड़े जाल मा सुई वे हाय जाल मा सुई वे हाय जाल मा सुई वे सुई वे सुई टंगे पर छत्तियों मेरी सस बड़े कपति जाल मा सुई वे हाय जाल मा सुई वे हाय जाल मा सुई वे
Excellent.
Thanks.
All right, we'll be back with the AMAs. With our thanks to Akriti and DAWgeek for joining us. It's called Swag Wali Bride. We'll
that's
be back.
That's right, that's right. Thank you.
Shunya one. $1 billion acquisition. Another copycat startup got formed.
No, The tech world in India is surely moving double the speed of this voiceover.
Tune in to Shunya One every Tuesday to catch us talking to the smartest people we know on the IVM Podcast website, app, or wherever you get your podcasts from.
If you have any questions for Cyrus, write to us on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. Or you can send an email to whatcyrussays@gmail.com.
Okay, we're at the AMAs. I don't know why I have to say that because, you know, it's just smooth transition from another crappy episode
when
of Cyrus
say
Says.
We are at the AMAs. It makes me feel like we're at some music awards.
I grew up on Jim Morrison, you know, so a lot of the introductions are, you know, you're at something. Okay. He wouldn't understand. Do you remember Jim Morrison?
I know who Jim Morrison is.
Yeah? Okay. Sing one Jim Morrison song.
Come on, baby, light my fire.
Not
you
bad.
You needed
why
me to say
you,
the
why
word
did you
come
do
on.
That, Amit?
Because I said, come on. I said, like, dude, what the hell? How can you not know anything?
I know, but I was just, like, thinking. I was thinking
kind
of the first
Mac
line as well.
Boy, are you.
I know
you
Jim
do
Morrison.
Not understand our culture.
I have
you
seen,
do not know our
I've
music.
I've seen Val Kilmer.
You are no longer a Mac boy.
I've seen the movie.
Val Kilmer. Yeah, he sang himself.
He was great in the movie.
So, like with the Americans, they make them land up singing themselves.
Yeah, exactly.
What are the sex scenes? The sex scenes are done by them themselves, or how does that work?
I would have to assume so.
I think so. I think most of the time. Yeah. Of course, depends on who you're sleeping with in that particular film. If you're a senior actor, go on.
Okay, but we have to be sensitive about it.
No, I thought we would segue into that straight off.
Yeah, go ahead.
So we have this this movement that's going on. I hope I don't sound patronizing.
Patriarchal
or sexist, which is the biggest bad word in the world.
Yeah.
And lots of people have been accused of lots of things in Hollywood. Let's not get into India. Nothing happens. Nobody ever pours anybody here.
Of course.
Yeah. But in Hollywood, they're falling like flies from a fan, which is a metaphor.
The flare has continued to 2018 now.
Yeah.
Yes.
Now, Aziz Ansari, Indian origin comedian from there. Yes. I don't know why we say that because he's completely American.
Yes.
So tell us the story, Naveen. What exactly happened?
So an article came out on babe.com after Aziz Ansari
won. Now remember, it's on babe.com.
Yeah.
That's your first clue. Right. Yeah, go on.
Right after he won the Golden Globe, a day after the Golden Globes, the article basically was written by a woman called Grace, and she alleged that he went on a date with her in September last year. And this was around the time when he was still working on Master of None and the show had come out. He was getting great reviews. And they went on a date and then she went home with him. At that point, she felt that he was being very sexually charged and trying to force sex on her. But if you read the article, there's a lot of...
There's a lot of gray here.
It has been studied by independent journalist Amit Doshi, who will tell us.
And it's been I've been following Twitter all throughout the past 2 days. And
I do not doubt it.
And people in two, right? Literally, right? There's a big conversation around, like, you know, like, of course, Me Too matters and Time's Up also matters right now after Oprah's speech.
Mm-hmm.
But was this voluntarily, like, you know...
Yeah, hello. Yeah. Nobody's knocking movements and, you know, nutcases who are trying to attack and molest girls.
Yeah.
But you were talking about a simple date that went wrong?
Yeah. Well, I don't even know if it went wrong, right? I mean, like, as you read through the entire article, right?
And
you
she did indulge in some sort of sexual acts with him?
Like, and she said no. He said, okay, fine. I mean, like, you know, that was pretty much it, right? You know, I mean, like...
So let's understand. He propositioned, she said no, and the matter ended.
Well, no. It actually... So he proposed. So they went for dinner. They came back. They got naked. They indulged in oral sex. He said, I want to have sex. She said no. He said, okay, fine. And I mean, like, then he called her an Uber and sent her home. I mean, like,
Did he pay for the Uber?
Well, if he called for the
was
Uber,
it from
then
his
he
account?
Probably paid for it.
There's no guarantee in America. Things change all the time. I presume that was the bone of contention. He didn't pay for the Uber.
I think, yeah. She wanted a vanity van.
Yeah. But what the hell is she doing naked in an Uber? Yeah.
But it seems that, you know, I mean, like, when you get stuff like this, right, you have these... you have issues like this which come up. It really, really kind of detracts from the real issues that are there. Like, so one of the things I read, one of the articles I read, which was supporting Aziz Ansari after this, it was a feminist in New York Times. And she was mentioning the same thing that, you know, I mean, like, the thing that got lost in this whole Aziz Ansari thing is the Elisha Dishku thing. And that is, like, a serious, serious issue where she was in True Lies at the age of 12 and she was molested by the stunt coordinator. The guy who was responsible of kind of...
which is an actual crime. This pedophile getting involved there. Totally different.
And you're the stunt coordinator.
The crime, the Aziz Ansari story, the crime I find for me is the fact that he didn't make a laugh. I mean, I thought you should make a laugh. Award-winning comedian, why aren't you making a laugh?
So we've already established, like,
especially when you're butt naked. Isn't that one of your acts? Isn't it?
Like, she's probably saw his
penis as a comedian, one of our go-to things is, okay, now I'm going to be nude if I don't have a joke.
Yeah.
She saw his penis and, like, Master
of
None,
right?
So,
got your point.
Like, now, I don't know where do we, like, even draw the line, because if you're going to a date voluntarily, if you voluntarily go and sit on a dinner table and then go to a...
Also, as a man, what do you do? The women say they want honesty. What are you supposed to do? So I've always been sort of straight up.
Yeah.
I don't... I thought, I can't understand what to do. Yeah. Now he'll have to rewrite his book, Aziz Ansari. His book is, which is a guide to how to pick up women and talk to them, etc., etc.
Yeah.
He's going to have to rewrite the whole thing.
Yeah, I don't know.
Dating is a longer process than you think now.
It is. I mean, like, enthusiasm.
It'll be like EMIs for you to take it up a little bit, take it up a little bit. It's not going to be easy. Women and men, if you can stay with your own genders, it'll be more preferable. I think, is that a better idea?
I think that's a better idea.
That's a better idea.
See, because, see, women understand emotions and they want emotions more. Other women can give them.
Don't elaborate. We don't have that much time.
I'm just saying.
Yeah, okay.
It's so much easier being gay. You
know, you're telling me. I've been applying for long.
To the wrong counters.
No, as you see in India, no vacancy. No vacancy.
All right. First question that we have today for you is there a cure for Arnab or is this prevention better? Briefless attorney asks.
But, you know, it's very simple. It's called a remote. Yeah. It's not that difficult.
I think I have turned on the Republic TV channel exactly once in my life, the second day after it was on, just to see what it was. And after that, I never turned it back on.
Yeah. This TV is asking you to pay more for Republic. I'm like, nope.
Yeah, why would you?
Why is this even an a la carte pack?
Yeah. I think now a channel should come with a diktat saying, you know, right-wing channel, left-wing channel, channel which has mobile phones on while we're chatting.
That can't sorry about that.
No worries. Is it Arnab? Is he upset?
Yeah. He's already, yeah.
Take the call. Because the Cyrus says, wants to know. Yeah.
Next question. So what happened to Winter this year? Did God forget to put on his AC?
Beautiful question. Who's this great person?
Anuj.
Anuj, I love you. I respect you. I will kiss your feet. Amazing. They promised us 3 months of winter. We got 2 weeks.
Such a
2 weeks. January 3rd, it was over. Yeah, declared done.
It got hot, man.
It's
hot. It didn't get 35 like,
degrees Celsius
cold.
Yesterday.
Yeah. And now you remember, you people who wore sweaters and were sarcastic. Now you remember what it's like. You know, it's amazing. The best part is the only time that they figured out the air-conditioned train and decided to run it across Bombay was in the month of January where we do have some cool. Yeah, we really need after that. But yeah, I don't know. This weather world, what's happening?
I don't understand.
All over the world, actually.
Well, I mean, like, yeah.
It's all over the place, weather.
Everywhere. Well, hey, global warming.
But it doesn't. Really. Donald says it doesn't exist.
He's clearly right.
He's clearly right.
Like, what to dread more, the summers this year or the nuclear holocaust?
Let me explain to you, Naveen. It is only one season. It's called summer.
It's called summer, yeah.
We have a summer, and then we have a hotter summer, and then we have a very hot summer. There's nothing else.
So, you know, I got a question. What do you think about that Hawaii thing, man?
That was ridiculous. But, you know, there's more to it than meets the eye.
Uh-huh.
Whether he was trying to do a prank or whether he was trying to actually send a warning because he misunderstood about some systems failure. So, because they've only moved him. They've not sacked him.
Huh.
No, so there's a lot more to
this. It was an error.
And people catch on so
error.
Fast as
he
well.
He sort of misunderstood that it was worse than it was and he sent a message. All right. So from his perspective, he's reacting to an alarm. Right. So in that sense, there's no error.
Right.
Okay, the error is the fact that it actually didn't happen.
That wasn't there.
And Twitter goes berserk with these things. Then everybody's like...
No, but listen. Yeah. In the world we live in, if we were in Hawaii, what would you have done? They cut in CNN.
But panic situation, I think...
People are making last phone calls to their wives, girlfriends, children.
People do that now also. And on WhatsApp also, people spread all these rumors.
You're on the Virar fast. Then you have to.
That's true.
You don't know how long you're going to be there.
But like 10 uncles discussing the same right-wing agenda.
Yeah. Really, is it?
Yeah. It's all... But that day, I was buying a smoke somewhere.
You should do a whole stand-up on trains.
Yeah. I have a set on trains, Please check my trial show out when it comes out.
Yeah, Naveen's trial show. It's out on...
Feb 11th and 10th. And 10th.
And 10th at...
At Cuckoo Club in Bangalore.
Cuckoo Club. And limited seats, so come fast.
Buy your tickets fast.
Yes.
Oh, it's not free?
It's on BookMyShow.
It's on BookMyShow.com.
Alright, last question. Back in the day, Iqbal Abdullah was one of my favorite IPL players because of KKR.
Yeah, struggling to make the team.
Yeah, what do you think about him now? He's nowhere to be seen, Lavanya asks.
Well, 1 year ago, he was very much to be seen. Mm. He's a Mumbai boy, left-arm spinner and can bat a bit. But this is the T20 generation. You don't perform for one season, you're out.
Yeah.
It's almost like the world. We have to keep
his name
performing.
Was all over the place in the
legendary status is for nobody.
Hmm.
No, if you don't perform in most forms of life, you're out.
You're out, yeah.
Hmm. It's a very critical world we've got into. You're just replaced automatically.
It's a data-driven world, man.
Absolutely.
You're just a cog in the machine.
Absolutely.
So initially, I thought even Virat Kohli was like this T20 wonder and he would like, you know, fade out. But
okay, don't talk cricket, Naveen. That's not even funny after some time.
I watched cricket earlier.
What the hell are you saying?
Now I've like lost
that he was a T20 phenomenon? Never. He was under-19 captain who won us
a
World Cup.
Exactly,
that was his first claim to fame.
Yeah.
He batted on when his father died in a Ranji Trophy match and came back and continued batting. Alright, so there are all kinds of stories about him. It's got nothing to do with T20.
Additional trivia, you know, I don't know.
I'm just telling you, he's a test match player.
You were looking for a lecture, man. I mean, like, you made a statement,
never,
you threw
never.
A bomb, you knew you were waiting
two
for
two things you never talk like... about in front of me is sex and cricket for different reasons. Alright, cricket because I know and sex because I don't. Stop!
The way I do it.
Oh, one for you, bro. Okay, catch us on any of the podcasting apps, please. We beg you, we need you. If you have any questions, write to us online and you can mail us as well. We will answer. We have a doctor in the house called me.
And that's what Cyrus says.
There she stands, a podcast addict. Outside the bank, having traveled several miles to get in with other poor souls like her. The journey, though daunting for this youngling, will have some comfort because she has downloaded her favorite podcast. You can see more of her species on ivmpodcasts.com, your one-stop destination where you can check out the coolest Indian podcasts. Happy listening.